Okay, good morning students. Last class we have discussed something about this solvent extraction process, but now it is a practical class. But this practical class is converted into theory class because already we have completed practical syllabus regarding practical content, whatever it may be given by the University semester 6. That's why we come to the point, the theory classes, the chapter solvent extraction. I thought this is also we have completed already, but revision process we have to discuss once again. So you know very well this solvent extraction process or solvent extraction techniques, there are mainly three types of solvent extraction process are there. They are, number one is batch extraction, second one is continuous extraction, third one is counter current extraction. These three are the widely used methods in solvent extraction techniques. Okay, so here you know very well solvent extraction techniques means any of the solute dissolved in a solvent, we have to separate that solute from the solvent or liquid. For that purpose, there are mainly three methods are widely used. One is batch extraction, second one is continuous extraction, third one is counter current extraction. So here generally distribution of the solute at the equilibrium state is the main important. So here we have to know something about Nernst distribution law, because here the Nernst distribution law somewhat applicable here solvent extraction process. Okay, so here last one, counter current extraction, otherwise called Craig counter current extraction. Craig is the name of the scientist, that's why it is sometimes known as Craig counter current extraction. So here number one is batch extraction, second one is continuous extraction, third one is counter current extraction. So these three methods are important at the semester end examination also. Repeated times the questions are repeated. Write the batch extraction in the solvent extraction process, or write the continuous extraction technique in solvent extraction process, write the Craig counter current extraction in solvent extraction process. So we have to discuss batch extraction and counter current extraction now. Later we have to see the continuous extraction. So here you know very well, so in general the solute is extracted from one layer by distributing it with a second immiscible layer. So here the solute is extracted from one layer by distributing it with a second immiscible layer. So here we have to observe three different diagrams having here. So all of you look at the board. So this is a apparatus we have to use in the solvent extraction process, mainly batch extraction process. In batch extraction method, the apparatus usually is separating funnel. The name of the apparatus used in the batch extraction process under solvent extraction. So this is the apparatus. The name of the apparatus is separating funnel. Separating funnel. So in this separating funnel, we have taken a aqueous solution of solute. So a solute is dissolved in a liquid that known as aqueous solution of solute. Here our aim is to separate solute which is present in the liquid or solvent. So for that purpose we have to add organic solvent or organic liquid to the aqueous solution of solute. So it is a in general immiscible with water. The organic solvent is immiscible with water which contains separating solute. So here generally ether organic solvent is added to the water or liquid which is present in the separating solute substance. So here then, so the name of the apparatus is separating funnel. Separating funnel. So next here, after adding organic liquid to the water, so just we have to shake the well, this separating funnel. Shake the well with the separating funnel. So then we have to fix it some time while. Then on shaking, solute A distributes ether and water layer. So here ether layer and water layer. After some time, after shaking, we have to fix it some time. Then we have to observe the formation of the two individual layers. The upper layer is ether layer. The below layer is bottom of the layer is water layer. Here the solute A is distributed in the equilibrium position. It distributes ether and H2O layer equally. So here equilibrium attains the solute. It distributes. That means solute A distributes in ether layer as well as water layer. Then next stage. So this is the stage 1. This is the stage 2. Then stage 3, we have to remove the water layer. So here the beaker is present. So just you have to use the nozzle, the drop the water layer. Here water layer is gets separated. Then remain we have organic solvent is present in the separating funnel. Organic solvent is present in the separating funnel. So here the organic solvent further undergoes distillation process. The organic solvent which contains solute further undergoes distillation process. Distillation process, then here we get the solute, then the solute is recrystallized in pure form. So in this way simply we have to separate the solute which is present in the liquid. So in general it is a batch extraction process. So what is the name of the apparatus which is used in the batch extraction process means here separating funnel. Separating funnel. So the solute is extracted from one layer by distributing it with a second immiscible layer. So water containing a solute, we have to add immiscible with water, one of the organic liquid organic solvent we have to add to that water or liquid which is present in the separating solute. So here the solute is extracted from one layer by distributing it with a second immiscible layer. So here solute A. So here it is A means the name of the solute A. So solute A is distributed equally in the ether layer as well as water layer. In the solute, in these two layers against the equilibrium. So attain the equilibrium. It's when it's happened means on shaking solute A. On shaking solute A distributes ether and water layer. Distributes ether and water layer.
So in this way we have to know the batch extraction process. So the apparatus which is used in the batch extraction is a separating funnel. So this separating funnel is used in the batch extraction process to separate the solute present in the liquid by adding immiscible organic solvent. So here selective removal of one or more substances from a mixture of substances with a solvent is known as generally extraction. Extraction of components from a solid mixture using a solvent is liquid solid extraction and is known as selective dissolution. Extraction of components from a liquid mixture using a solvent is liquid liquid extraction and is known as solvent extraction. The liquid used as a solvent for extraction is known as extractant. So here the what is the theory of solvent extractions means heterogeneous systems consisting of two immiscible liquids are widely used for separating substances by extraction. One of the phases is usually water while the other is an organic liquid immiscible with water. When the two phases, that is aqueous phase and organic phase, come in contact, part of the substance to be separated is transferred from one phase to another. This process is reversible. When dynamic equilibrium is reached, it can be characterized by an equilibrium constant K known as distribution constant. So K, that is equilibrium constant K, is called concentration of substance to be extracted in organic phase divided by concentration of substance to be extracted in aqueous phase. So generally this is the theory or principle involved in the solvent extraction process. So just we have discussed about batch extraction process. This is the simplest and most widely used method. So batch extraction process or batch extraction technique is the simplest and most widely used method. This method is used where a large distribution ratio for the desired separation is possible. In this method, the solute is extracted from one layer by distributing it with a second immiscible layer. In general, in batch extraction, a given volume of an aqueous solution containing the solute is shaken with a given volume of extracting organic solvent in a pear-shaped separating funnel. The two layers are agitated thoroughly by shaking the separating funnel until partition equilibrium has been attained. The layers are then allowed to settle out. The two layers are separated by draining of one layer at a time. The organic solvent is removed by distillation to get the solute, which is further purified by crystallization. So here just you have to observe these three pictures, that means separating funnels. So in this separating funnel, picture A shows the ether is added to aqueous solution of A. So all of you look at the picture 1, that means stage 1. picture 1. So here first we have to take the aqueous solution of solute A in a first separating funnel. So first separating funnel containing aqueous solution of solute. Aqueous solution of solute. So to this we have to add organic solvent that is known as ether. So ether liquid, organic liquid is added to the aqueous solution of containing solute A. So ether is immiscible with water. So ether, that is organic solvent which is immiscible with water. The solute is extracted from one layer by distributing it with a second immiscible layer. So here the second picture shows, second separating funnel shows, on shaking solute A distributes between ether and water layer. So here we have to observe the shaking the separating funnel until partition equilibrium has been attained. So here generally the separating funnel having the two layers, at that time by shaking the separating funnel until partition equilibrium has been attained, the layers are then allowed to settle out. The two layers are separated by draining of one layer at a time. The organic solvent is removed by distillation to get the solute, which is further purified by crystallization. So second picture shows the on shaking solute A distributes between ether and water layers. Ether and water layers. So that is equilibrium attained. Equilibrium attained. Solute A distributes equally in ether layer as well as water layer. So here equilibrium has been attained. Equilibrium has been attained. So generally third picture shows ether layer is separated by running out the water layer. Ether layer is separated by running out the water layer. So here in general we have to observe these batch extraction, continuous extraction, counter current extraction. So here in the solvent extraction process, when two mutually immiscible or partially miscible liquids are brought in contact together, the substance or substances to be extracted will distribute between the two liquids in a definite way, concentrating predominantly in one of them. This process is known as solvent extraction. In other words, removal of a solute present in a solvent using another liquid which is immiscible with the original solvent is known as solvent extraction. So here extraction arises from differential solubility of a solute in two mutually immiscible liquids. In this extraction process, one of the liquids is usually water and the other is an organic liquid. In such processes, advantage is taken of the fact that the distribution ratio of most of the inorganic substances is in favor of water, while most of the organic substances is in favor of organic solvents. This is due to the fact that organic compounds, that means non-polar or less polar covalent compounds, are generally more soluble in non-polar organic solvents like benzene, ether, carbon tetrachloride, chloroform, etc. than in water, and most of these organic solvents are immiscible with water. Hence, organic compounds are easily extracted into non-aqueous organic layer when an aqueous solution containing both inorganic and organic compounds are brought in contact with an organic solvent. Finally, the non-aqueous layer is separated from the aqueous layer and the solvent is removed by distillation to get the organic substance. So here the solvent extraction process, we have to observe these main points. So in the solvent extraction process, we determine the iron also. You determine the iron by solvent extraction process. Okay, so here now let us see the batch extraction process. Batch extraction process. So next, then we have a counter current and continuous extraction process also there. So now let us see continuous extraction process. Continuous extraction process, that means, okay, so before continuous extraction, let us see now third technique. What is third technique here? Counter current extraction. So it is also one of the important question, counter current extraction. So now let us see counter current extraction. So what is meant by counter current extraction? How is the technique, how we can separate the solute in counter current extraction process? Okay, in general, in any extraction process, two phases are involved. You know well, one is known as mobile phase and the other is known as stationary phase. So we discussed about these two phases in chromatography techniques. You know very well, different chromatographic techniques we have learned in the last previous classes. Okay, so you can take any chromatography technique. Mainly there are two types of phases we have to observe. One is stationary phase, second one is mobile phase. One is stationary phase and second one is mobile phase. So here one is known as mobile phase and the other is known as stationary phase. The extraction involves the flow of mobile phase past the stationary phase. Such methods are known as cross current methods, and in them only one of the phases is continuously renewed. In counter current extraction, both the phases are renewed. In counter current extraction, both the phases are renewed. The sample to be extracted stands still. One of the two phases moves by it in one direction while the other phase moves in the opposite direction. Components of the sample, that means if it contains more than one substance. So components of the sample will have different tendencies to be pulled in one way or the other depending upon their K. Here K means the distribution coefficient. K means the distribution coefficient values. In this counter current extraction, contact between two phases takes place in large number of discrete steps. This technique was developed by a great scientist, L.C. Craig, and hence this method is sometimes called Craig's counter current method. Craig's counter current method, and the apparatus used in this method is known as Craig's apparatus. Similarly, in batch extraction, the apparatus used is separating funnel. So here also in counter current extraction, generally the apparatus used in this counter current method is Craig's apparatus. Craig's apparatus. So here in the Craig's counter current extraction is also very simple method. Very simple method. So here both the faces are renewed. That means the sample to be extracted stands still. One of the two faces moves by it in one direction while the other face moves in the opposite direction. Components of the sample will have different tendencies to be pulled in one way or the other depending upon their distribution coefficient values. In this counter current extraction, contact between the two faces takes place in large number of discrete steps. This technique was developed by the scientist L.C. Craig, and hence this method is sometimes called Craig's method, and the apparatus used in this method is known as Craig's apparatus. Okay, so it is the Craig counter current extraction method. Next, coming to the very simple method, second one, continuous extraction. Continuous extraction. This process of continuous extraction is used where the distribution ratio of a solute between two immiscible solvents is low. This method makes use of continuous flow of an immiscible organic solvent through the aqueous solution to be extracted. Although partition equilibrium may not be achieved during the time of contact, the solute is being removed continuously using the extracting organic solvent. If the extracting organic solvent is volatile, that means, which is true in most of the situations, it is recycled by distillation and condensation. In such situations, the organic solvent is dispersed in the aqueous phase with the help of a suitable device like sintered glass disc columns and mixture settlers, spray columns, rotating disc columns, etc. We have to be used. So it is also very simple method, the continuous extraction process. So we have to discuss these three methods in solvent extraction process. Okay, are you following or not? Okay. So it is one of the most important topic regarding the solvent extraction process. So you know very well the solvent extraction process. Mainly there are three techniques are widely used. Just now we discussed about that. So one is batch extraction. One is batch extraction. Second one is continuous extraction. Third one is counter current extraction. Counter current extractions. So in the solvent extraction process, there are mainly three techniques are widely used to separate the solute present in the aqueous solution by adding immiscible organic solvent. That organic solvent is not mixable with water. That solvent we can add the act as a solution which is present in the solute.
So here, what is the first method? Batch extraction. Batch extraction, that means here solute is separated step by step. Step by step. So here these three diagrams regarding batch extraction process. So the name of the apparatus is known as separating funnel. Separating funnel. So generally in batch extraction process, solvent extraction, the widely used apparatus is very simple apparatus, that is known as separating funnel. In general, we observe in our chemical laboratory general funnel while separating the precipitate and filtrate. That is a glass funnel, or sometimes we have to use plastic funnels also. So here it is a one type of peculiar type of apparatus that is known as separating funnel. Separating funnel. So in batch extraction process, we have to use the apparatus is separating funnel. So these three diagrams regarding batch extraction process in solvent extraction technique. So second one is continuous extraction. Third one is counter current extraction, that means Craig's counter current extraction. So in counter current extraction, both liquids are moves in opposite direction. So this technique was developed by the great scientist Craig's. That's why in the memory of his name, this method is known as Craig's counter current extraction. So here, so batch extraction, then continuous extraction, then counter current extraction. So these three methods are involved in the solvent extraction process. Solvent extraction process. So you know, where the solute is extracted from one layer by distributing it with a second immiscible layer, that is the principle here. Sometimes Nernst distribution law also here we have to apply in the solvent extraction process. So you know very well. So now it is a practical class, so far we have completed the practical syllabus. That's why instead of practical class, we have discussed in theory class, that is solvent extraction methods. Okay, are you understand or not? Okay, understood. Okay, very well, very well. Okay, solvent extraction. So here just now you have to write down the one simple assignment regarding this topic. So what is the principle involved in the solvent extraction process? So what is the principle involved in the solvent extraction process? So what are the techniques involved in the solvent extraction process? So next question, write the batch extraction technique. Next, write the continuous extraction technique. So next, write the Craig's counter current extraction technique. So these are the questions under assignment. So if time permits, we have to conduct a simple test on solvent extraction process. Okay students, so next to be continued in the next class. Okay, so remaining topic regarding this solvent extraction to be continued in the next class. Okay, so when you feel leisure time, write the answers to that assignment questions now what I have given to you. Okay, thank you very much.